Hello students, today we are going to study about the defect of vision. In that last video you have studied about the, you have listened, means I have explained you about the defects, four defects. Today we will study it more clearly, okay, one by one. As last video I have told you that this defects of vision is not in your exam, but still you are going to study it. Okay, so listen carefully, this is very important for your future. Means whenever you will study about the human eye, you should know at least the defects you should know. Okay, in daily life also it may be helpful for you. For that, first defect is, here you can see, first defect is hypermetropia or long-sightedness. So what is hypermetropia? Hypermetropia is also called as long sightedness. This is very important for your exam. Question can be asked that long sightedness defect is also called as dash. Okay, so here this is a little bit confusing as you are studying. It is new for you, it may be confusing for you, because in this two, short sighted and long sighted. Okay, mostly students get confused between myopia and hypermetropia. Don't get confused. Okay, so in such questions, you will write the answer, that is hypermetropia. I will tell you. See, this is long-sighted. Means what? Actually, what happens, as I have explained you, this is the normal vision. See here, this is the normal vision. This is the object. From the object, light rays fall on our eye. It enters into our eye through pupil, then to the lens. It is focused to the retina. If it is properly focused on the retina, then what happens? It is our normal vision. Okay, if the light is focused properly to the retina, it is our normal vision. But if there is any defect in the falling of this light on the retina, then it comes under the defect. Okay, so what is defective eye? Why it is called as defective eye? If this ray, if it doesn't falls on properly on retina, if it goes, what happens? There is some condition, because aging and because different factors, what happens? This light may fall beyond the retina, or it may fall between, inside or in front of the retina. It doesn't fall properly. Means this is a defect in our eyes. So we can say that such type of eye is a defective eye. Okay, in this is the first defect you are going to study, that is long-sightedness, which is called as hypermetropia. Okay, now here you can see, this is the object, as I have explained you normal, I will explain you about this first disease. Here this is the object. Okay, the light is falling on the object, and the light falls on the object, it reflects to our eye. This ray enters into our eye through pupil, then to the eye lens, then adjusting the focal length, what happens? The rays falls on the screen, but you can see here, it is not actually falling on the retina, it goes beyond the retina. Okay, you can see here, the point here, it is beyond, it is behind the retina. Okay, so what happens? You will have, if the light, this ray is not falling on screen and it is going, means it is not falling on retina, if it is going beyond that, then what happens? You can say that defect is called as hypermetropia or long sightedness. Okay, see the condition, what is there? Focal length of eye lens is too long. Why? These are the conditions that why this happens. Okay, why it happens? Because the focal length of the eye lens is too long. Means here, this is the eye lens, and the focal length of this eye lens is too long, and because of that, it doesn't focus at the screen, it focus beyond the retina. Understood? Here retina, screen means your retina, screen of our eye is the retina. Okay, and it falls on the, beyond the retina. Okay, so this, how it can be fixed, that also I'm going to explain. But see, why what are the problems, why this happens? So first problem is what? Focal length of this is too long. Second is eyeball becomes small. Sometimes what happened due to aging or some different problems, what happened? This eyeball becomes small. And because when the eyeball becomes small, what happened? Then also this hypermetropia can occur, okay? Or this defect can be occur. And how it is corrected? Here it is written, you can see here. It is corrected by the convex lens of appropriate power. Okay, means what you have to do here, if you will put a convex lens, okay, as you all know that this lens, our eye lens is also a convex lens, and what happens here, you are using a convex lens, means what, which convex lens you are using? As you know, to correct this defect, many people use spectacles. Okay, spectacles means what? You are using extra lens over there to correct this defect. Now how you are going to correct this defect? You have to take this it is not focusing on screen. You have to take it on the screen. You want to take this rays which is falling beyond the eye, you have to take it on the screen. To correct this much defect, you have to put a convex lens, means you have to use in a spectacle. If you are using a convex lens of appropriate power, what is appropriate power? Now you know, you are telling, some students are telling, my number, spec number is 1.25 or 1 point something, okay? So such things means what is that? That is the correction of this defect. Means if you are putting a convex lens, suppose this eye has a defect of 1.25 lens, if you will put, his eyesight will get corrected. Means suppose this lens is of 1.25, then what happens? This this ray of light which is falling behind, it gets adjust or it gets focused on the retina by using the convex lens. Understood? And this adjustment or this focusing on the retina by using a convex lens, or it is a corrected, it is a correction made by using a spectacle. So that when you are using a spectacle, what happens? The ray is correctedly fall on your retina and you can see properly. As you can see the difference when you are removing your specs, how you can see, and when you are putting your specs back, you can see the corrected vision. Okay, so this is called as long-sightedness. In long-sightedness, what happens? The image which is formed, or the rays which falls, it is beyond the screen or beyond the retina. Okay, and that disease is called as hypermetropia. Now we will study about the myopia. Myopia is what? It is a short-sightedness. Means in this, oppositely, here the sight was beyond the retina, here it will be inside this. Okay, or in front, it is not properly falling on retina, it is falling in front. Here also same, you can see this is short-sighted eye. Here this is the object, light rays falls on the object, it reflects on our eye, then on the eye lens, and then it doesn't falls on the retina, it falls in front of the retina. Now here what you have to do, you have to make little bit correction in our eye, so that here as it falls over here, you have to make this much correction, you have to make. So you will put a lens of this much, they will detect how much there is a correction, and that much power lens they will put here, so that this eyesight will fall on the retina. Now here what you have to do, you have to increase the focal length over here, so that the light will fall on retina. Here what you have to do, you have to decrease that focal length. Okay, here what you are going to do, you are going to increase the focal length, so that instead of here, it will fall on the retina. Okay, so as you have used here convex lens, here you will use concave lens. Okay, in short sight you are going to use, this is very important question can be asked, which type of lens is used to correct the short eyesight or to correct the myopia. For myopia it is concave lens. Concave lens is used over here. Now you can see when you are using a concave lens, then what happened? This eyesight will be corrected. Now it will properly fall on the retina. Okay, now why this happens? What are the symptoms or what are the effects behind this defect? So first one is elongation of eyeball. Means what? Here your eyeball elongates. Elongates means what? Elongation of eyeball means now is due to age or due to some problem. What happens? That's the elongation, means at this much it is your eyeball. It elongates, means it becomes like this. it becomes stretched, little bit stretched, or it becomes short. If it will become like this, then what happens? It elongates. Okay, elongation of eyeball is one condition. Second condition, distance between retina and eye lens increased. Now, if you will see, this is the eye lens and this is the retina. If it elongates, what happens? The distance also increases from the eye lens and the retina. If this decrease distance increase, what happened? Then eyesight, you can the image, the ray which falls, it will fall in front only, it will not fall on the retina. Then you can see decrease in focal length of lens. As I have told you here, focal length increases in long sight, and in short sight focal length decreases. For increasing this, what you have to do? You have to use a concave lens to correct the defect. Okay, so this it is called as myopia. Okay, still if you have any doubt, you can ask me. Thank you.